Good evening. Thanks for joining us. More rain preparing to roll into the Triad less than 24 hours after heavy rain led to dozens of rescues in the Gate City.
Meteorologist Michelle Kennedy is tracking it all. So, Michelle, we've heard lots of warnings come in. Who is at risk for flooding tonight?
Well, right now, actually, parts of Forsyth and Guilford County are at risk. You can see the storm here brewing just within the last 2 hours. The storm rolling in eastern sections of Forsyth, western Guilford County, and you see it here as those clouds darken, heavy rains bringing in anywhere from 1 to 2 inches, lots of lightning. And you can see also over Belews Lake, folks there have been impacted. We're expecting to see some of the lighter rainfall totals coming in from them. The good news is that as I'm looking at radar right now, you notice what we've seen drop out just within the last 10 minutes. The lightning, the intensity of the lightning has dropped, and that is a good sign often that that storm is beginning to weaken, and we've seen that right now. Oak Ridge, Summerfield just getting in some of the lighter rain. Walkertown still under heavy downpours along 311. So this is where we could get those 0.5 to 1 inch totals still going for a little bit longer, but overall the storm is beginning to fade. We're still seeing some concerns here from Brightwood as we go south along 29 and western sections of Guilford and downtown Greensboro. So advisories up until 6:30. You can see it here from Belews Creek down through Summerfield, Kernersville, covering a large portion of western sections of Greensboro. And so until we go into the 6:30 hour, we're expecting to see at least 2 inches in spots, and then some of those rapidly rising creeks could create some problems in the neighborhood. So watch for that. You're right now at 81 degrees, rain cooled in Greensboro, a cooler Winston-Salem at 78 degrees. We have much more for you coming up and talk about more storms that are coming through tonight.
And as Michelle mentioned, parts of Greensboro are already getting ready for more rain. Because of this, more than 40 people were rescued because of the downpour last night. This was down in Latham Park or Latham Road, and heavy downpours sent Buffalo Creek out of its bank, submerging several cars, leaving behind a muddy mess. The flooding hit places like Wendover Avenue, Lindley Park, and Latham Park.
And our Steve King joins us live from the location there with how some neighbors are there cleaning up from the storm. Steve?
Well, most of the water rescues that took place last night in Greensboro happened here in Latham Park, or at least in this general area. And it wasn't just the Greensboro Fire Department putting it all on the line to save lives. We spoke with a man who was driving here along Latham Road, got stuck in the floodwaters, and a man who lives here along the road actually pulled him to safety using his truck. We're hearing from the man who was rescued tonight.
The guy was a hero in my mind. Stupid on my part to come down the road, but as everybody says on the news channels, you guys, is, you know, turn around, don't drown. So I won't make the mistake again. So
Eisenhower says the man not only pulled him to safety, but helped pull Eisenhower's SUV from Buffalo Creek. And because of that man's efforts, Eisenhower's SUV might not be totaled. Meanwhile, these same floodwaters along Latham Road that came from Buffalo Creek got into some houses along Latham Road. Those waters totaled 3 of Aaron Spears' family's vehicles, and they got into her crawl space as well, damaging some household items. Now her family is trying to clean up.
You know, at this point, it's just, you know, put your head down, get it done, and see what happens next. And glad to have a good support system. You know, everybody is really kind of making the best of the situation, I think, and that's really awesome.
Also, last night's heavy rain and winds caused this damage at the Airport Market gas station on Regional Road. There was flooding outside the Revolution Mill apartments as well, but managers there say no apartment units were damaged because they have flood barriers in place for all apartment units close to the creek there. Now, coming up at 6, we are going to hear an owner of a small business who's talking about the floodwaters and the impact they had on her small business and why it's making it so hard for her to get her small business, which, by the way, is new, up and running, and just how challenging everything is. But reporting live in Greensboro for now, I'm Steve King, WXII 12 News.
To stay ahead of the storms, download the free WXII 12 News mobile app. You can check the interactive radar anytime and be alerted when severe weather is headed to your neighborhood.